outbreak of the case of World War One.
Beautiful.
For Germany, during the case for us as in Vietnam, or as a perceived solution to the economic ravages of previous wars. Alright? So that brings us to stage number six here. And in stage six, the wealth transfer that is caused by the expansion of this currency supply is felt by the population as severe super price inflation, triggering a loss in faith in the currency. This is what has started to happen for us. We went on a fiat currency in 1971 when the Bretton-Woods Agreement was passed. Today in stage number six, so since 2010, over the last 12 months alone, we've seen an average increase in price. The price of the
$6.
We all know that the cost of a gallon of gasoline has gone through new records recently. And we've all seen, it's actually pretty funny. My wife just the other day mentioned that she had her eye on a new purchase, and the person actually received a caller and said, hey, the price of this entire line, this designer's line, is going to go up like 40% next week. So if you want to buy the purse, buy it now. Well, we're seeing the price of food go through the roof, which caused the price of Egypt. We see the price of energy and gasoline go through the roof. We're seeing the price of all commodities and products and goods go through the roof right now. So that is where we're in stage number six. So for stage number six, I want you to put inflation. And that finally obviously brings us to the final stage, stage number seven. And when a nation gets to this point, an in mass movement out of the currency into precious metals and other tangible assets takes place, the currency collapses, and massive wealth is transferred to those who had enough foresight position their money in the right asset class beforehand. So for stage number seven, I want you to go ahead and put wealth transfer. Now, we are right here between stage six and stage seven. The primary symptom, again, of stage number six is price inflation. As I just mentioned, during the calendar year 2001, we've seen a massive spike in commodity prices to the tune of 46%, which is just a minor hint of what's to come. So, knowing this back in 2007, I was able to invest my money into certain asset classes that increased in value as the economy and the dollar steadied, hoping to earn a return of what is now the time to be right, 105%, while most of the world lost it.
I don't know how you do it.